Hello, everyone. Welcome to Inconvenient Truths. I'm your host, Jennifer Zeng. Have you ever wondered why Xi Jinping is so dead set on the so-called zero COVID policy? And why did the CCP push so hard to have everyone vaccinated, but with made in China vaccines only? Who actually benefited from the million-dollar vaccination business in China? Today, I have some shocking and exclusive information about how Xi Jinping's family is related to SinoVac, the number one COVID vaccine producer in China. I'm sure you haven't heard about this from anyone else. First, let me give you a very brief introduction of SinoVac. According to its own website, SinoVac's COVID-19 vaccine, CoronaVac, has been granted emergency use approval or conditional marketing authorization by over 50 countries or regions worldwide. These are some basic numbers and facts about SinoVac. Since it was granted emergency and use approval in June 2020, it has produced about 3.4 billion doses of its COVID vaccine and has sold about 2.8 billion of them. Its net profit last year was about $14.5 billion, and this is an increase of 7,729 from the previous year. In terms of net profit, it is second only to Pfizer. See these numbers. SinoVac's net profit is even higher than America's company Merck and Moderna, whose net profit was $12.3 and $12.2 billion. Only Pfizer's net profit is higher. Now, how is SinoVac related to Xi Jinping's family? On December 4th, 2020, that is 6 months after SinoVac obtained emergency use approval, it received an investment of over $500 million from SinoBiopharm. And after this investment, SinoBiopharm holds a 15.03% interest in SinoVac, which is traded on NASDAQ. Now, look carefully at the screenshot of SinoBiopharm's website. You can see it belongs to CP Pharm, which is in turn belongs to CP Group, or Cheronkin Phat Group. I don't know if I'm pronouncing it right. So it is a leading company in Thailand. And furthermore, SinoBiopharm's executive director and chairwoman, Teresa Xie, holds another 0.35% interest in SinoVac. And who is Teresa Xie? Her Chinese name is Xie Qirun. So she ranked among the 10 richest women in China in 2019. Xie's family is not only incredibly wealthy, but also has an illustrious history. The CP Group, founded in Thailand in 1921, is one of the world's biggest multinational conglomerates today, controlling more than 400 companies in over 20 countries. And Teresa Xie's grand uncle, Denning Cheravanot, whose Chinese name is Xie Guoming, is senior chairman of the CP Group and was once the richest man in Thailand. And this is a photo of him. At Tiananmen Tower, he was invited as a special guest to observe the CCP's National Day ceremony in 1915. He also has the honor to be received by four generations of the CCP leaders. So this is a photo of him with CCP's leader, Deng Xiaoping. And this is a photo of him with CCP's leader, Jiang Zemin. And this is a photo of him with CCP's leader, Hu Jintao. And this is a photo of him with CCP's current leader, Xi Jinping. From this long history, you can see how deeply this family is connected with the CCP. As a matter of fact, after Deng Xiaoping started his so-called reform and opening up to the outside world policy, CP Group was the first foreign company that obtained a Sino-foreign joint venture business license in China. See, this is the business license granted to CP Group in 1981. This license is now displayed at China's National Museum as part of the celebration, as part of the exhibition to celebrate the 40th anniversary of the CCP's reform and opening up policy. Now, here comes the most important part of today's story. How is the CP Group related to Xi Jinping's family? According to a popular Chinese language YouTuber, Jiang Feng, who is also my personal friend, you can see he has 894,000 subscribers. He revealed in his show for members only that according to reliable sources in China, Xi Jinping's nephew Xi Zhengming, also called Xi Zhengming, secretly married Xie Qirui or Teresa Xie in March 2020. Now, let's look at Xi Jinping's family tree. Xi Jinping's father, Xi Zhongxun, was once vice chairman of the Standing Committee of the National People's Congress of China. He was considered to have made a great contribution to the CCP and one of the eight most important CCP first generation leaders. Xi Jinping's mother was Qi Xin. One of Xi Jinping's brothers is Xi Yuanping. He is currently the president of the International Association for Energy Conservation and Environmental Protection. And Xi Zhengming or Xi Zhengming is the son of Xi Yuanping and his first wife. Xi Yuanping is currently married to his third wife. Now let's check these photos one by one. So these are Xi Jinping's father, Xi Zhongxun, and his mother, Qi Xin. And this is an old photo of Xi Jinping and his brother, Xi Yuanping, with their parents. And this is a family photo of Xi Jinping. The little boy in the red circle is Qi Zhengming or Xi Zhengming. Xi Jinping is standing right after him, and beside him is Xi Jinping's father, Xi Zhongxun. Why does Xi Zhengming or Qi Zhengming has two names? Officially, he should be called Qi Zhengming and follow his father's surname. I guess because this family wants to cover up his true identity. So in some of the reports, he is also referred to as Qi Zhengming. Qi is Xi Jinping's mother's surname. As Xi Jinping doesn't have a son, so naturally, Xi Zhengming or Qi Zhengming is the eldest son of the third generation of this family. In terms of family heirs, he is the most important male in this family. So you can see why he was arranged to stand right beside his grandfather, Xi Zhongxun, the head of the big family. All the above photos, the three photos of Xi's family come from a People's Daily article. In this article, Xi Jinping's new view was referred to as Xi Zhenming. And this is a photo of Xi Zhenming. He was referred to as Dr. Xi Zhenming from Tsinghua University. And the photo comes from this report about Xi Zhenming's activities in Yibin City, Sichuan Province in China in 2019. From the top photo, you can see it was a fairly large event. This report is also about Xi Jinping's activity in Yibin City. The title of the report reads, Dr. Qi Mingzheng, Chief of the Grassroots Practice Detachment of the Yibin Cadre Training Class of Tsinghua University, conducts field researches and investigations on firefighting work in Lingang Economic Development Zone. The report also says that during Qi Mingzheng's visit, Yang Jian, director of the party's government office of district management committee, accompanied him during the whole process. You can see someone showing maybe some firefighting equipment to him. And this photo is also from that report showing that Lingang Fire Brigade instructor introduced the fire safety situation to Qi Mingzheng. And this is a group photo of him with the entire firefighters team. He is the tallest guy in the middle. And this is another official report of Qi Mingzheng's visit in Yibin City. You can see the tallest guy in the photo is again Qi Mingzheng. 12 official CCP officials in this district, including again Yang Jian, accompanied him. You can see one official was eagerly reporting something to Qi Mingzheng as if Qi Mingzheng were a big boss. And this are two other photos from the same report, which says Qiu Jiazhu, deputy secretary of the party working committee of Xinjiao Street, and Wu Yanlan, secretary of party committee of Jinshajiang region, accompanied the research team. So have you ever seen any other PhD student at Tsinghua University receiving the same kind of treatment? I haven't, for sure. So from this, I'm very much convinced that Qi Mingzheng is just Xi Mingzheng. In this family photo of Xi Zhen, in this family photo of Xi Jinping, he is referred to as Xi Zhenming. It's a little bit confusing. So if Xi Jinping's new view, Xi Mingzheng or Qi Mingzheng, secretly is it true that Xi Jinping's new view, Xi Mingzheng or Qi Mingzheng, is secretly married to Teresa Xie or Xie Qirun, the heiress of CP Group? According to Jiang Feng, yes, they are married. Internet rumors have it that Teresa Xie or Xie Qirui is married to Zhang Kangyang, the president of Suning International, but Jiang Feng said that was disinformation purposely released to cover up the real situation. Now, let's go back to check our facts. As mentioned earlier, Teresa Xie's company, Sina Biopharm, invested 500 million US dollars in SinoVac in December 2020, and thus obtained 0.3% interest or shares in SinoVac. That happened 6 months after SinoVac obtained the emergency use approval. We all know that for pharmaceutical companies, the most difficult period is when it is doing research and development. On the other hand, when the product is already on the market, especially for a monopolistic product such as the SinoVac vaccine, the only thing it needs to do is to sit there and wait for the pouring in of profit. Why would it introduce a new investor at such a stage to dilute its equity and profit? So if SinoVac's net profit was 14.5 billion US dollars in 2020, for Sino Biopharm, which made the investment in December 2020, it could have 2.16 billion US dollars. And Teresa Xie could gain 50 million US dollars more for the share in her name. According to SinoVac's financial report, it did not pay dividends to shareholders in 2021. But in theory, that was how much Sino Biopharm and Teresa Xie could gain. Another thing to take notice of is that Teresa Xie and Qi Mingzhen secretly married in March 2020. 3 months later, in June 2020, SinoVac obtained emergency use approval from the CCP. Another thing to take notice of is that 45-year-old Cao Xiaobing, senior manager of the Government Affairs Center of SinoVac Biotech Company, suddenly died on April 17th this year. The company said he died of disease, but didn't say what kind of disease. And he was so young, only 45 years old. And as his title was senior manager of the Government Affairs Center of SinoVac Biotech Company, some people think his sudden death is very suspicious. Did he know some top secret that made him too dangerous to be alive? Not only Cao Xiaobing, but several other high-ranking experts in China's vaccine industry also died suspiciously. For example, Zeng Bing, vice mayor of Dalian City, who was once the vice general manager of Sinopharm, another main COVID vaccine developer and producer in China, died on July 23rd this year at the age of only 55. He was said to have died of disease, but again, we don't know what kind of disease. And Dr. Sinova Shijafra Bachtia, sorry if I pronounce her name wrong, she's the lead scientist on China's SinoVac vaccine trials in Indonesia. She died of suspected COVID-19 on July 7, 2021 at the age of 52. And Professor Zhao Zhendong, a researcher at the Institute of Pathogen Biology, Chinese Academy of Medical Sciences, died on September 17, 2020 in Beijing at the age of 53. The official media only announced his death 2 or 3 months later. He was once instructed by the CCP's National Health Commission to head the technical support team of the vaccines research and development task force related to the CCP State Council, and was responsible for giving ideas to 12 R&D institute in China. And 周玉生 the CCP's military microbiological the CCP's medical expert in this area mysteriously died in May 2020 at the age of 54. He had won many rewards before he died, but the CCP didn't report about his death at all. People only knew about his death when his name was listed as a deceased or author in the paper. He had already applied for a patent for a COVID vaccine as early as February 24th in 2020. That was only 5 weeks after the CCP admitted that COVID was human to human, and the WHO had not even declared a pandemic yet. Well, I guess that was too much information for one show. So all in all, actually what you really need to know is that Xi Jinping's family may have a huge interest in SinoVac through a secret marriage between his nephew Qi Mingzhen and CP Group's heiress, China Biopharm's executive director and chairwoman Xie Qirui or Teresa Xie. Absolute power always needs to